changing the world. If radio has been a way for me to bring joy to the world, it's also been a way for me to help change it for the better. I have reveled in finding ways to rally listeners behind a cause that can turn small actions into making a big difference. In El Paso, we challenged everyone to do something that hadn't been done for decades. Stay alive during the Christmas New Year holiday. Calling it the Pepsi Challenge, we offered to buy everyone in the entire city a Pepsi if no traffic deaths were reported. The city responded, and no deaths occurred. A series of Pepsi parties were then held at local malls to make good on our promise. During the great drought of 1977 in Los Angeles, the Metropolitan Water District needed a way to inspire citizens to conserve on all levels. I suggested a water-thon, similar to a telethon, but on KMPC radio with callers pledging gallons that they would save instead of dollars. I asked my dear friend, songwriter Alan O'Day, to rewrite and record Paul Simon's 50 Ways to Leave Your Lover, changing the lyrics to 50 Ways to Save Your Water. Major stars converged on the station for 24 hours, joining my fellow KMPC personalities to make their plea to save water. And indeed, the conservation of over 100 million gallons was pledged by thousands of listeners. In the days that followed, usage went down dramatically. The United Nations proclaimed 1979 the Year of the Child in an effort to draw attention to children's problems throughout the world. Through the kind efforts of L.A. child advocate Gwen Kirk, I was named representative of Los Angeles County and traveled to Washington to meet the U.N.-appointed chair, the late Jean Young. My proposal for Sunshine Day, a national holiday for children, was adopted and celebrated across the nation on August 24, 1979. The idea was to spend the day outdoors, giving children what they most want, time and love. One morning in March 1985, I woke up to the voice of a child on my clock radio singing the words to the Michael Jackson, Lionel Richie anthem to end world famine, We Are the World. My first thought was, what a great idea. Children singing this powerful lyric. Then I realized that what I heard was actually Michael Jackson singing his part of the song. I shared the idea with my listeners on KMGG radio that afternoon in Los Angeles and immediately received hundreds of calls from volunteers and children wanting to be a part of what we called the Children of the World Project. 2 months later, after auditioning over 1,500 talented youngsters, we entered the studio to record with Grammy-winning producer George Duke. A video was also made a week later, and we included hundreds of children who had auditioned in the closing scene, shot at L.A.'s Griffith Park. Proceeds went to USA for Africa, and the song received a Grammy nomination. While some say the war on drugs, championed by Nancy Reagan in the 1980s and 90s, was a losing battle, I beg to differ. After personally delivering over 1,400 motivational school presentations for the cause and standing next to the First Lady while hosting the national rally at the Washington Monument, I can truly say our efforts have not been in vain. Millions of children who have heard our message have enjoyed a drug-free life. They are the ones you don't hear about. In 1997, the city of San Antonio surprised me, renaming the Sonny Melendrez Community Center as a way of saying thank you for my contributions to youth. It is an incredible honor usually reserved for those no longer with us. To date, we have raised over $100,000 to benefit the disadvantaged youth served by the center in one of the poorest areas of our city. Now, I humbly offer these social statistics not as a self-pat on the back, but as a testimony to the human spirit. Everyone has the ability to give back, and sometimes needs only to be asked, encouraged, and shown the results of their efforts.